What's up everyone, this is Ken. I wanted to do a video today to recalibrate my battery, the BMS. If you don't know what that is, it's battery management system. The BMS is what really manages your battery, and it's good to reset it sometimes. If you're just charging up to 80% every day, 90%, or whatever you do, you're really not going to know the capabilities of your battery and see exactly really how many miles you have left. So I have around 11,500 miles on my car right now. I want to get it down, preferably to single digits. Then I will go and supercharge it all the way back up to 100%. I don't know how long that'll take, but one thing I'm very excited about, where I'm going, they have a new supercharger, and it's a 250 kilowatt supercharger. And that's the fastest out right now. And it's, I think, a 16 stall supercharger. So that's gonna be very exciting. So you'll see me later. You'll see me, it'll probably be dark. It'll be later in the night. I'm trying to drop my battery down a lot right now. You know, I have a long range battery. So right now I'm at around 50%. I'll only be around 25%. So I gotta do a little bit more driving. I'm gonna get me something to eat at my favorite restaurant first. And then you're gonna see me at the supercharger. I'll kind of explain to you kind of where the car thinks it is right now. And also I'll probably use the stats app and see what it thinks the battery is. And then I will charge it up and see where it's at. I'll see you there. All right, so I'm back. So I'm just in an open parking lot. I gotta do some more driving. You see right now I'm at 109 miles to go, which is not always accurate at 32%. I always use the percentage. The distance I've traveled is 134, if you're curious. Total energy is 30 kilowatts per hour, and the average energy is 222. What I'm gonna do now is pull out the stats app, and I'll put that up on the screen and show you what the car thinks my car will be at 100%. So let's do that. And then once I get to the supercharger, we're gonna see if it's pretty accurate. My guess is gonna be around probably 343 miles is what I'm gonna have. The stats app, it's really, really good. It gives you estimated range, gives you rated range, and it's showing around 341 is the rated range. Estimated range is way higher. My driving efficiency is 110%. Miles per gallon estimated is around 148. So it's telling me my max range is 343. It's better than 93% of other similar cars with similar mileage. That's what I figured, and I didn't cheat because it's been that number for a very long time. I'm at 15% right now, if you can see that. Now I'm just doing regular autopilot because I don't want it to turn off anywhere. I just want to just pretty much go in a straight shot. If I put it in the navigation, it's still saying it's going to be a little bit longer. It's like 1249 right now. And let's see here. Still saying like 12%. I don't know if you can see that. So we still got a ways to go, and I will catch back up with you when I get closer.
Excuse me.
What?
I'm so sorry, man. You don't have like $2 you can help us out? We just got stuck.
I'll give you $5, okay?
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Hey, here you go, man.
Bless you.
Hey, you too, man. Hey, take care.
If I would help you out with something,
You good.
Okay.
I'll show you where we're at. I think I'm good. I'm going to head to the supercharger. Right now, I'm at 12%. When I get to the supercharger, it'll say 6%. So I'm cutting it close, but hey, I want to make sure I get a good estimate on the battery and see how well I'm doing. See you there. Okay, so I'm sharing my screen again so you can see. I'm gonna move this bar. You see that little bar right up above my car? It only shows 334 at 100% if you saw that. So I'm gonna go back, 334, just like it says there in the middle. So we're gonna see what I can get. Should be ramping up here. We're at 115 kilowatts right now. And I've never charged this fast whatsoever. And we're gonna see if we're gonna get up to 250 kilowatts. There's nobody here but me. We're up to 230 kilowatts. It's going fast. And we're at 1,100 miles per hour. We've already added 5 kilowatts and we're already at 15%. Hopefully you can hear that. That baby purring, do you hear it? So look like it's backing back down, but that's okay. We got up to, I think around 240, is at 235 right now. So right now the current session, it's just been look like around $4. We're already at 21% and we arrived here at 9%. So it's very, very fast. Didn't get up to 250, got very close to it, but I'll let you know at the end how much it costs to charge the car as well. Okay, so it's 1:58 a.m. We are at 90% and it's even slower at 32 kilowatts, getting around 146 miles per hour, 15 minutes left, which that could be 20-25 because it's very slow and it's charging the battery all the way up. The grand total so far, $25.55. At 90%. It is a little expensive these days to charge, kind of like with gas, but it's definitely still cheaper. See in a little bit. 2 minutes left, but it was saying 1 minute, but it jumped up to two, and that's how it is with charging up to 100%. It'll bounce back. It could be another 10 minutes before it hits 100% because we're at, it's saying 100% right now, and my battery is saying 341 and it's saying that the charge limit is 343. I'm hoping we get to that 343. I want to see if I had a battery loss of at least under 1%, a little bit under there. So I'll get back with you. It's 2:34 a.m. right now, so we're gonna see. Okay, it's complete. So let's unplug so we don't get any kind of idle fees. and then we'll get this video closed out. Goodbye, Supercharger. This is what I ended with, 343. My EPA on this car is 353 and 11,725 miles. I have lost only 10 miles off of my battery pack. This is a more accurate representation of how my battery is doing.
Okay, everyone, this is the conclusion of the video. It's like 2:40 in the morning. I'm tired, I'm ready to go. These are some pointers I can leave with you, especially the ones that has lasted through this whole video. Number one, if you need to charge to 100%, I recommend you do not do it, not unless you really have to. With that being said, if you are on a road trip and your car is telling you that you have to charge to 100% to get to the next supercharger, by all means, do it. Number two, you should really do this every once in a while. Don't do it once a month. I try to do it maybe once every 6 months or something. But just think about it. That's not too bad. 11,725 miles, 17, almost 18 months of driving this car. And out of 353 miles, I still have like 343. I'm not saying it's probably the best. I wish it would be 353. The EPA estimate, but I'll take it. And if you're curious of how long it took to charge, I think it was probably over like an hour, maybe an hour 30 minutes, something like that. It felt like forever, but I'll put that somewhere like right here. Don't forget to hit that like button and hit that subscribe button if you see fit, and also hit that notification bell as it will notify you when I do post videos. This is YouTube Ken. I'll see you in the next video.